Hello henna lovers, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to draw paisleys, two types of paisleys and a peacock. So we will begin with the basic shape of a paisley. So let's begin with the first one. So the first paisley that we are drawing is in a upside down position. Here I am drawing an S shape, but it has a little curve over here, and then I am twisting or turning this end and from the top part again I am pulling down other half of this paisley. I'll show you the mirror image of the paisley as well. For the mirror image or for the flip image, I would be drawing similarly the first half of the paisley in opposite direction, likewise, and from here I'm going to pull this part down and making it come to the end where the where it meets up the first curve of the paisley. So while drawing these kind of paisleys, to get them correct, the trick is to understand the distance between this puffy part or the belly, we can call it a belly because this is also how we are going to draw a peacock. So this becomes the peacock's belly. So we need to understand the difference between the distance between the belly and the mouth or this curve, and then to get it correct we have to make sure that they are getting they are kind of aligned. If you see here, I'm making the marking, so these are in a in a straight line. If you draw in between them, they are kind of right across each other. So this is one type of a paisley where the bottom of these paisley are bit pointed. Now another paisley that I'm going to show is the one with a rounded bottom. For that paisley we are going to draw an S shape, a kind of a S shape. But in this S shape, we are going to make the second half of the S a little bigger than the usual S. In the letter S, we have both the parts of similar size. But here we are going to make it a little bigger and then turn it around. And instead of making it pointy, I'm making it look rounded. And then bringing this end to meet the curve part. So this is another paisley. Let me show you the mirror image of the same. Here you can exactly draw the similar way as I have drawn here. Like you can draw the first half in an opposite direction, like an opposite S, and then make it circular or rounded and then bring it to the end. Or you can also draw the same thing in opposite direction. Sorry. Like you can draw this half first and then from the other end you can bring it here and then you may want to close it like this. So this is a little difficult for me to draw. So if you see, I have made a little mess here. So this is the right technique actually, where you are drawing, this is the first part of the paisley and this is the second part, or this is the step one and this is the step two. So if you go according to these steps, you are going to get the paisley into right shape. And again, you need to make sure that the mouth of this paisley or the curve of the paisley and the belly are aligned with each other. Okay, now let's move on to drawing the peacock. In the peacock as well, we are going to draw, it's something similar, but with peacock, we are going to begin with the face or the mouth of the peacock first. So here, I'm drawing an oval shape. And drawing an S shape from the one end. Again, if you notice, I'm bringing this part in a position where it would be aligned to the mouth or the face of the peacock. And then this peacock, again, I can either make it pointy, and here from the neck I'm bringing it down and making that end meet over here. So here in the peacock's neck, the neck of the peacock is an important part to make this shape make sense, like as a peacock. If you make this neck bigger, thicker or wider, then it's not going to create the effect or the look of the peacock. So the neck of the peacock should always be as lean and as narrow as possible. And then here we are going to draw a beak. Also, while drawing the beak, make sure that as closer to the belly as you could draw, you're supposed to draw it like that. If you bring this, let me show you. If you draw a peacock like this, and I'm purposely keeping these two ends on distance, and then if you draw the shape likewise, and if you make the neck thicker and bring it down, and then also the beak is far away from the belly, then this is, if you notice the difference, this is how it's gonna look weird. The thick neck and the beak that is going far away from the belly. So this is not how we draw a peacock. This is the right technique of drawing the peacock. Now let me show you the mirror image of the peacock the other way around, like the flip side. Or if you want to draw the face towards on the right hand, this one you can draw on the left hand or the left side. I'll show you the other one from the right side. So we begin with the face first. So the face of the peacock is always in an oval shape, and it is always supposed to the ends of these oval shape are always supposed to be closer to each other so that we can pull the neck down and make it look leaner. And here I'm bringing the belly of the peacock right underneath its face, and then drawing the neck of the peacock. So you don't necessarily have to go from in a clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. It's up to you, whichever way you find it more convenient, or as you slowly develop your practice, how easy, whichever way you find it easier, you can do that. And now the belly part that comes down here, and the beak again. The beak in the traditional Indian design is always thin and closer to the belly, so that way the peacock looks more elegant. Now let's see the eye, how to draw the eye of the peacock. So there are two, three different styles with which you can draw the eye. Let me show you the first way, where we are drawing a kind of a petal inside his mouth, and then we are going to fill this gap with a thick line like this. You're going to fill this up completely, and then we're just gonna put a little dot, and that's how the eye of the peacock is made. Also make sure always to fill the beak with the paste, and to give it a nice elegant look. Now let me show you one more way of drawing the eye of the peacock. So I would just draw the face over here. Again, I would be drawing a petal kind of a shape inside, and fill this up. And here I'm going to draw a pretty thin line or a curvy eye shape, and then I would be giving it a little dot. This peacock gives a little more like a human feel. So there is one more or couple more types of eyes of the peacocks are there, with which you can, like, you know, there are a couple ways with which you can draw the eye of the peacock as well, but I'm not going to show that here, because that's going to be the part of my advanced tutorial. So make sure to watch that tutorial as well once you practice these basic pastelies and peacock shapes. Now I'm going to show you how to fill these the filling of these pastelies and these peacocks, how to begin with that. That's what I'm going to show you next. So let me draw another paisley over here. So I'm just going to draw a simple shape of the paisley. Again, if you see, I'm just making an S shape over there and bringing this to close the end. Okay, so usually these kind of paisleys are either filled beginning from the end or from the top. So let me show you the first one, beginning from the end of the paisley or the bottom of the paisley. So when it comes to fill the shapes, it's all about your creativity, but still there are certain standard shapes or elements are there that you can incorporate. So I'm just using some basic swirl and the lines around and a bump line, and then a bigger bump line on top of it. Then I would going to fill it up, as this paisley is pretty small. I may not have a lot of elements to fill in. So it also depends on the size and the the placement of the paisley in the design where you make it. Depending on that, you need to choose your elements that you are going to put in to the paisley as a filler. So that part basically depends upon your creativity, how you want to go for it. And that's how we end. And then never ever forget to redraw another line after you are done with the filling. You have to draw one more line on top of it. This is called as a polished line or a finished line, with which your shape is going to look more it will stand out in the design by doing or by applying this last step. So that's how you fill up the paisley. Let me show you another paisley as well, the opposite direction, and let's go for a rounder shape paisley. Okay, so here I'm going to place some different elements. So the choice is yours. You can either fill the paisley with the same element or with a different element. So the one that I'm showing you here is with the same element. So the entire paisley would only be filled up with the swirls and then two border lines around it. Also, this paisley is a little bigger than the one that I have drawn earlier, so I could have filled it up with various shapes, or sorry, various elements, but then I chose to draw a little bold or a little bigger swirls, which also looks beautiful in this kind of a big paisley. So while filling this up, always make sure that you're not leaving any unnecessary gaps. See, as here I did not had enough space to draw a swirl, so I just drew the lines over there but did not leave that place empty. So you make sure that no unnecessary gaps or no there shouldn't be any space left out where you haven't put the filler element. And here is the polish line, and that's how we end. So here you can also turn this inside and give it a look, give it a dot and then make it look little different. So it's, as I said, it all depends upon your creativity. So this is how we fill up the paisleys. Now let me show you how to fill up a peacock. So as we have a peacock ready here, let's begin on that itself to save on time. So for peacock, I would like to begin, or this is how usually the artists, you might have seen, they begin from here when it comes to the filling of the peacock. And as you see, I am using my index finger as a guiding finger, and as this is a pretty narrow space that I have got here, I have chosen small swirls. And then as I move forward, I'm going to fill it up with some big elements. I'm going to fill this up. And I'll be drawing a border line, maybe couple border lines. Then again, I'm going to draw the bump or the hump line. If you haven't watched my tutorial where I have talked about various types of bump line and how to draw the straight line, I would recommend you all to watch that video, because the hump line is something that we are always going to use, every now and then we're going to use in our design, whether it is a traditional Indian design or a Arabic design. We always need these humps, especially in the traditional Indian design. We're gonna need this, and that is what going to give the nice elegant look to our design. So it's very important to understand the difference between those hump lines and how to draw them. So here I'm going to fill this spot up, and I would be drawing a nice grid pattern, the basic grid pattern, to finish off with the filling of the peacock. My henna paste is little loose today, so you may see the big lumps in the beginning, at some places. It's not usually this thin. And then I'm going to end up this design with the polish line. This is actually going to thicken your element or the shape, and then it's going to give the more visually it looks much better than the thin lines, and it also stands better, the borders and everything when they are a little thick, they stains well, and then the reflection of these element as compared to the these borders is that altogether it gives it a nice look, this light and the thin and thick difference that you show in your design, that's going to create a different look. So this is all about our paisley and peacock tutorial for today. So as I mentioned earlier as well, always make sure that you draw the neck of the peacock pretty close and lean as much as possible, and then do never ever forget to draw the polish line when you finish with the filling. So these two things, and then as I have mentioned all other details, if you implement these techniques in your practice, you will see the difference in your design in no time.